Hello. Good morning, everybody. My name is Ananda Hota. Good morning again. I'm so happy to see so many people just getting the message, mostly from email and Facebook, right? Facebook works. Gmail is very formal almost. You don't need sign letter, right? Wonderful. The moment you start believing that internet connectivity can make something happen in reality also, that's what this is an example. And slowly, we will, before the live stream starts, I cannot say much more, but I'm really so happy because this is where, first time in Bangalore, I got my astronomy education formally in an Institute of Science. So that's what my first astronomy teacher, Professor Arnab Raj Chaudhary, will be speaking in the afternoon. So what I learned here, I'm starting to propagate again. I'm very happy, really. I'm a very informal person, so it is not that I'm confined to this lecture only. So connect with me through Facebook, our group. All the badge holding people, they are now trained that whatever you will be learning in this session, they can guide you later on also. They will help you to make this kind of image of selfie with black hole. You already know that this is an interesting title, and real meaning is slightly different from this, right? Otherwise, you would not have come. Nobody takes selfie with black hole. We're waiting for time, simply. How many of you are from MSc, BSc background? Raise your hands, please. Okay. And some of them are from BTech, MTech background. How many of you? A bit larger. Sorry. And how many of you are not in MSc, BSc, BTech, MTech, that kind of student life? One, happy. Two, three, four, five, six. Anyway, message is the last batch, actually. Students are very serious. They are interested in getting into the profession of what kind of research they are interested in, what kind of study they can get so that they will give them the job. But the rest of the people who are in different kind of job, this platform shows that you are passionate about astronomy. And my decision science program, Red at Home, that we have been learning, this is actually mostly focusing on those kind of people. We are slowly growing. It is almost 5 years. But this is what is the message, that if you are passionate about something, from your free time, you can do something that will help professional astronomers publish research paper. If that is using our own telescope, our own country's telescope, our own taxpayer money, then we'll be more happy, more proud, right? That is what is the purpose. How can the educated mass start contributing something to the real research that the country's scientists are doing? That is what is citizen science. We will listen more about that. Go in Google, go in Wikipedia, search what is citizen science, and think basically how you can be part of that. Not necessarily for salary, but self-satisfaction. That is more important sometimes. Even if you have a job, of course you are not happy, you have to change job. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, people in the net. We are a platform where most of the work is will be happening in the internet. So you are more welcome than anybody in the research platform may have welcomed you. I'm Ananda Hota. I work in University of Mumbai Department of Atomic Energy Collaborative Institution, that is Center for Excellence in Basic Science in Mumbai. Similar to ICER and ICER, we are also BSMS degree giving institution. And I'm a University Grant Commission Assistant Professor there. I am the principal investigator of this Red at Home Citizen Science Collaboratory. So I will be giving you a brief introduction how sitting in the internet, mostly using NASA Skyview platform and Facebook, you can join our collaboratory, Red at Home Collaboratory, and start learning more about galaxies, black hole galaxy coevolution, and start contributing to real research by this kind of participation, which is called citizen science. So this selfie with black hole, the attractive title, is to propagate a message that galaxy images are not necessarily the most beautiful Hubble Space Telescope taken images. You on your own can also analyze the galaxy images. What HST says, what the picture you get. You can use not only the optical picture, but also infrared, ultraviolet, radio images of galaxies and black holes. Black holes ejection process, rather. So that way, if you start making your own images, you change the images according to your willing. And that is how the image will change, means what you have changed, you know. So almost like a tuning a radio and catching different station, you start analyzing the galaxy images, emission from black hole accretion process on your own. And develop your own understanding whenever you are free. That is what this selfie with the black hole thing is, that you can do it on your own. Image the active black holes which are creating some kind of plasma jets from centers of galaxies. Take a selfie. Why? Because you feel proud, you are happy about, and you want to show your happy face as well as the black hole ejection process. So we will be making that kind of images, primarily made with our own Indian telescope, Giant Meteoroid Telescope. It has taken a survey, TGSS, and those TGSS survey images of whole sky in 150 megahertz, roughly around the FM radio station you listen, we'll be taking those images, use NASA Skyview platform, and add optical images, add another radio telescope image of NBSS from VLA in USA, and understand what this multiple images combination means. So, after this brief description, I will ask you to make your own telescope images, own RGB images, red, green, blue. Red, green, blue, where the red will be Indian telescope GMRT image, green will be DSS optical image of sky, and blue will be NVSS VLA images from the USA. So these images will be combined into RGB images, red, green, blue images, and you will be posting those images in the web for description of what you understand about it. And these, while you post, you will be tagging Red at Home as well as ICTS, so that people interested in this, they will come more to listen ICTS public talks, and they will come more and join Red at Home to further analyze, further understand the galaxies. And in the next Red at Home Discovery Camp, they will be joining as a trained, to be trained member. And all the people wearing badge here are that kind of trained citizen science now. They have been trained here for 6 days. And those trained citizen science will be communicating with each other and with the research scientist through internet, sitting at home. And that is how they will be given new data. They will be analyzing and finding something, new black holes, new black hole, new ejection from black holes. And that is what is that your selfie, your images that you make can be part of a research proposal with Giant Meteoroid Radio Telescope, with the international team, and you will become the co-investigator in those proposals. So this is your starting point, as described in your announcements. This is our first step in learning RGB image analysis of galaxies with active black holes. Once you know this, then slowly you will be joining the collaboratory. You will come to a camp, which will be hosted by ICTS, Institute of Physics, Nehru Planetarium, different places in all over India. And once you get trained, then that kind of trained people in a network will be researching with us. So there are more than 110 students that I have trained in the last 5 years, different institutes, hosted our camps. And here, we have got 21 students this year. So these are the trained citizen scientists, or in our words, they are called e-astronomers, like email mail. So here, I will give you a brief introduction why this topic is important. Why you make your own image is not only important for your own understanding, but also important for the scientists that are really working on galaxies and black holes. So I will give you a picture that this is what my discoveries are. The right-hand side top, discovery of exotic galaxy Speca, black hole galaxy caught in the act, their feedback process, news from news releases from NCRT AFR, NRO, VLA, NSF, VLA, USA, and NASA Sky, NASA JPL Caltech. The farthest star also we discovered in the trail of a galaxy. So this is kind of my identity, that you can be trained in this kind of research, news making research, important research. So how you can be part of, like this I said, you can gather people from different parts of India and train them. They can make their own images of galaxies and black hole and be part of this kind of research. You all know this is galaxy, and galaxies are different kind. In Hubble deep field picture, they are of different distance, different evolutionary state in the evolution of our universe. Universe has evolved from almost uniform part. This is just simulation. I don't have much time to go for this, but this is what slowly universe evolves and starts forming massive clusters of galaxies. As they converge towards the centers of these clusters, our clusters are having 1,000, 2,000 galaxies. So things move forward. In this process, change happens, evolution happens. For example, from that same Hubble deep field, people have seen that this is far away universe, just 2 billion years after the Big Bang. This is nearby universe, roughly 14 billion years after the Big Bang. So this is current, close to our home, close to our Milky Way. Galaxies are either spiral or elliptical. But if you go back in time, you don't see that quite well-defined shape. This difference is so basic, almost like a plant and an animal. You know, there are very primitive living beings. It's difficult to say they are plant or animal. Sometimes similar to that, the galaxies are not well defined, almost like they have not decided what they want to become. They want to become a spiral or elliptical. At a popular level, one can say this way. So when you look back in that Hubble deep field picture, far away galaxies you observe how they are, nearby galaxies you observe how they are, and try to understand that things has evolved. But what are the physical processes that has driven this kind of evolution? So that is what we are, our purpose is. So black hole in the centers of our galaxy, they are mass, and the mass of the bulge part of the galaxies, they are correlated. So black hole at the very center, and the big galaxies are co-evolving, hand in hand. How they are talking to each other? We'll try to understand that way. So this is a plot called color magnitude diagram. Star-forming, blue cloud, star-forming spiral galaxies. And elliptical galaxies don't form star. But how elliptical galaxies form? A lot of people believe, and it is the most prevalent picture currently, that galaxies merge just by pure gravitational interaction. Electromagnetic force is much weaker at that large distance. When they merge, they form a lot of star. And in the simulation picture, you can see when the two spiral galaxies are merging, they are blowing away wind. The cold gas from the galaxies are blown away. The process, they form a elliptical-like galaxy with very little cold gas to form new star. So this is the current understanding. So the galaxies, which are elliptical, they don't form star. They are not spiral. They are only old star. Our sun is 4.5 billion year old. But they have come from merger of two spiral galaxies, where a lot of gas and dust is there, and where few million year old O and B type massive stars are forming. So the black hole outflow, black hole jet, is kind of shooting a elliptical galaxy. You can imagine that it has doomed the future star formation in elliptical galaxy. the black hole is the culprit who has killed the future of this galaxy. So this is the most attractive proposal so far. How to understand the spiral galaxy, black hole galaxy, what is the difference between them, how they have evolved from early universe to current day. But the smoking gun evidence, what you would call, that we can find an evidence that this is really happening today, and this can happen. It's not just a hypothesis, but we can see evidence for that. That is not really found yet. So what we should do, we should go to find some cases where this kind of smoke, old plasma, can be seen. And black hole, old plasma can be seen better in long wavelength. Long wavelength means GMRT, our own GMRT telescope range. So 150 megahertz is a very long wavelength, wavelength like 2 meter. 2 meter wavelength, like the bullet engine has been stopped, but the engine is still hot. You can feel from afar. Iron is hot, red hot iron. Once it cools down, it becomes still hot, not visible, not emitting light, but you can feel the infrared radiation from there. Similar, roughly similar, although the plasma that you are going to detect with GMRT is not thermal plasma, non-thermal plasma, you can still see the older plasma preferentially better in our own GMRT images. So let's see, we can find that kind of a old smoke, cold smoke, old relativistic plasma with GMRT. Where there is a galaxy, we should be able to see some plasma which was long back ejected by the jet. Can we see that? So galaxies are plenty. Survey images have taken image of galaxies in all wavelengths. So let's look at the radio wavelength so that can we see that relic plasma? Can we see that leftover plasma? Can we see the smoking on evidence that the black hole has killed the future star formation in the galaxy? This is what is a famous example. A lady found that what is this faint, funny object? They found this is a relic of previous ionization by a quasar. That quasar is no longer active. So similarly, we will be able to do this kind of a finding that the optical galaxy will be in the middle. Optical galaxy will be in green color. And the radio emission from 1400 megahertz American VLA telescope, that will be in blue. And Indian GMRT emission in red. So once you see no strong straight linear collection, but irregular shape on either side, that's a potential relic plasma. In the afternoon talk, I will go further than this, but this is what I will stop now. So anybody can make a red, green, and blue, and if you are a bit more advanced, you can make this kind of line or contour map. So that if you are finding a diffuse emission around any galaxy, you tell me now, I found a diffuse emission, can be the smoking gun evidence of the black hole feedback. If that is actually unpublished, if that is actually true, we will verify and we will check in the publication. You can also check in the publication after you get through the training and say that, yes, these are the evidences. If you find one dozen that the smoke is 10 minutes old, the person died 5 minutes back, it's okay. But if the smoke is 1 minute old and the person has died 5 minutes back, that is not the smoking gun. The event has to be before, then the person died. When the star formation in a galaxy stopped, if there is 500 million years, you have to find a smoke which is more than 500 million years, 600 million years, 700 million years. Then we have actually a chance that we can say, yes, the smoking gun evidence suggests that the future is stopped by the black hole's ejection process. We should be able to find that kind of irregular shape, PGSS or GMRT emission just beside this black hole which has stopped star formation. So you can make RGB images just by clicking different surveys in NASA SkyView. So we will, now you know this connection, you know the web access thing. And we will go to see how to make a RGB image of a galaxy that you want to post with selfie with. So I want you to open Wikipedia and Wikipedia's radio galaxy article. I don't have to give you a study material. If, we can start from everywhere something that is available. We'll go to Wikipedia. Can web open web here? Kira? Yes. Everybody will see. Open Radio Galaxy article. And look at some pictures there. So there are two kind of radio galaxies. Go down, you can see. This is a pure radio picture where the green color is pseudo color. There is nothing green there actually. This is a radio picture. So there are roughly two kind of radio galaxies known. Top one, where the radio emission is more bright at the outer edges. Jet comes out from the black hole at the very center. It supplies this kind of relativistic plasma. The plasma that is going there can be 10% speed of light, very fast relativistic plasma. So there is a lot of electrons, possibly positron and electron, but we don't know really protons are there or not. So definitely electrons are there all around, and relativistic plasma and the magnetic field, they emit non-thermal synchrotron plasma, like the radiation that comes out from a synchrotron when the electrons or protons are moving very fast close to speed of light. This kind of radio we will see in the blue and red image. Another kind of thing is this plume also, that it starts from the middle. Slowly it becomes faint. These are called edge brightened and edge darkened, two kind of radio galaxies. So that way, here, these galaxies, they have a name, 3C31 and 3C98. So open NASA Skyview now. We will make an image, red, green, blue, RGB image of. So how to go there? Simply search NASA Skyview. NASA Skyview Virtual Observatory. Click there. There is something called Skyview Query Form. Okay, click on the query form. Then you can put the name of the object, you can put coordinate. In astronomy, the coordinates are called RADEC, something like latitude, longitude. So let's put a name of the object, 3C31, that is there in the Wikipedia article, third Cambridge catalog, 31th galaxy image. There, we will be making an image, say, 900 pixel by 900 pixel. And put default. The batch holding people can help you immediately if you are struggling with that. You can distribute yourself. And say, how big is the galaxy? We really don't know currently. So you can put, say, 0.25, quarter degree. And go down, overlays, grid, catalog, RGB image. There, we'll put filter, which data to be put in which color. Here in red, we'll put TGSS ADR1 from GMRT telescope. And green, we'll put something like DSS, Digital Sky Survey, DSS2 red. And in blue, we'll put another radio picture named NVSS survey. NVSS. So we are now ready to make an image of radio, optical, radio. TGSS in red because there's a longer wavelength, GMRT data, and DSS in green, NVSS in blue. Ready? I have put only image size in pixel, image size in degree, name of the galaxy, and these three filters. Once you enter that, submit. Three different telescopes, three different country, three different wavelength, we are put in one single picture. Radio picture comes in, right? You got a picture? So now, some of you have got the image already. If you have got a color picture, raise your hand. Very good. Impressed. So that way, the green picture is optical picture, and red picture is the GMRT TGSS 150 megahertz or 2 meter wavelength, 2 meter wavelength radio. And the blue one is the NVSS, VLA, USA. They're radio emission in 1400 megahertz, roughly 20 centimeter wavelength. 20 centimeter wavelength radio waves and 2 meter wavelength radio waves. Both are combined together to understand the radio picture of this galaxy. And on the top, you are put also the optical picture. What you see? There are so many point sources. Most of them are 99% of them stars. Sorry, 99% of galaxy. You can see a Azon spiral galaxy. Can see an elliptical galaxy. So many, probably 100 optical galaxies you see far, far away, they themselves are 100 light year kind of size, but you see only one which is ejecting this kind of a plasma jet. That plasma jet is huge. Its own galaxy is just this much. Stars are there only this much size. But the plasma jet goes out order of magnitude 10 times, 100 times larger than the galaxy itself. So, important thing is this event of ejecting relativistic plasma from black hole is a rare event. It happens for 10, 20, 30 million years, at most 100 million years, not more than that. But the stars in the galaxy, like our sun, are several billions of years old. What is a billion year? Let me give you an scale to compare with. Time we take around for our solar system to go around the Milky Way galaxy is 300 million years, roughly. So three times of that, if it goes around, then only 1 billion years happen. And our sun has lived 4.5 billion years. So the stars in this system, most of them are 5-7 billion years old. But the plasma ejection is only a 20, 30, 50 million year kind of an outburst. So it's a blink. It's a very short term. It's kind of an explosion process. Galaxies live much longer. That way, this ejection process is not only going far, if something is on the way, this can also affect. Something is on the way, this can affect, means it can affect the whole own galaxy also. That is where we are interested in, right? That whether this black hole ejection affects the gas, affect the star formation of its own galaxy. So now we know this kind of picture, let's go to make another picture of the another radio galaxy that is there in Wikipedia, 3C98. You can go back to the parameter page, just change the galaxy name there, 3C98. Submit. Let's get another picture. We have not changed anything except the galaxy name. It was 3C31, now we are putting 3C98. If anybody is lost and not able to make an RGB image, raise your hand, somebody will help you. The trained citizen scientist e-astronomers will come to you and they will help you get the image. Fine. Now, can you see more bit detail? You saw that the host galaxy there, elliptical galaxy, green looking optical one, is in the middle. And the plasma that has come out is not seen coming out, but it has dumped its plasma farther away in either sides. So, this is called edge brightened, bright on the either side, FR2 kind of radiography. They are more powerful than the previous variety. Okay. Made a picture already. 3C98 in your screen. Raise your hand. Yes, majority can make. It's very easy. That's what I have been telling. That if you know where to make and how to make and what does it make, it's very easy. A long wavelength, GMRT image is in red, VLA short wavelength image is in blue, and optical image is in green. That's a powerful radio galaxy. So many galaxies all around, they have no ejection from their black hole. They are not active. Because this powerful explosion in the jet form is a very short time phenomenon. That's why you will see only few of them in that phase of their life. And most of them will not be like that. It is possible that most of them, like this galaxy, they already have this kind of ejection a billion years back. And you want to see that smoking gun evidence. If they earlier had a ejection there, if you see some kind of funny, fuzzy emission, faint emission here and here, that's what is to report. In this field, in this location, I see something. Yes. You cannot tell looking at the galaxy whether that will become a radio galaxy or not. What is only known that all the radio galaxies are hosted in elliptical galaxies, like which doesn't have spiral arm. So that kind of indirectly says, this is from the days of Jenison and Dasgupta discovered, that this kind of radio plasma are seen on either side of an elliptical galaxy only. So elliptical galaxies are more massive, so they are black hole at the center also more massive. So how they have grown is a theory, that the spiral galaxies merge and they become disoriented, there is no preferred rotation plane, and that becomes an elliptical galaxy. So elliptical galaxies will be hosting more massive and more faster spinning black hole. And this faster spinning massive black hole are more powerful engine to create this kind of jet. This has been the understanding so far, that why radio galaxy host our jets are coming out from elliptical. I will show you, I'm known for that, I will show you one example where the host galaxy is not elliptical. That kind of suggests an alternate way, independent way, that black hole can also grow and spin up and create this kind of jet. We will see that now. So just change the galaxy name again. I named it and it has been recognized. So SPECA, SPECA. Submit it. You'll get everything same except the galaxy name is different. It's a galaxy you see now, right? In your screen?
Excuse me. A lot of you are getting too many processes and the site is not working. So in that case, you just close your form and reopen it. It'll work. This happens when a lot of people are using the website.
This is the full image of that Speca radio galaxy. What has actually happened here, that the central galaxy, we'll zoom in and see, has created one pair of plasma lobe. And long back, 20, 30 million years back, it had another pair of lobe ejected. That's why the outer plasma is older, relic plasma, leftover plasma, and the inner one is the fresh one. Got it? So the plasma that is ejected, say 30 million years back, is this one. The plasma that is ejected, say 100 million years back, is this plasma, farther away. It is there in everybody's data, decade-old survey data. What was interesting is looking at this galaxy in the center. This galaxy is not an elliptical galaxy. It's an off-oddball, off-beat, crazy galaxy. That is what was interesting. You can see that zoomed in also. Suppose you zoom in, instead of 0.25 degree, make it, say, 125. Going wonderful. Fine, I am zooming in. I can see that the central galaxy is elongated, as on like spiral galaxy, right? That is what was the news-making discovery. The discovery of an exotic galaxy which is not just elliptical, it is actually spiral. It is not just one lobe, pair of lobe, it is two pair of lobe. Possibly there is one more third pair when we followed up with GMRT, much deeper observation. Then we saw one more inner pair. And we have followed up with big X-ray telescope, again with optical telescope spectroscopy and radio telescope also. It's a very crazy system, and it is going to help probably how first big galaxies in our universe form. How black holes are affecting those first galaxies. So this is what I mean by taking selfie with them, that you can create this kind of images and take a selfie with your laptop screen, post it on your profile, on your own profile, tag Red at Home and tag TGSS. We will, on our web Facebook page, we will give you the exact text what to do. Exact text I will be describing you. I will show it. There we'll post you where is the Facebook page that you want to tag, where is the Facebook group that you want to further learn and join, and what is the page for TGSS. You will get in your Facebook notification where you have signed up for the event. There we will post this. That way you can take a photograph of this and post it. That is just is the basic selfie with black hole message. If you have any questions, I can answer. We will go offline. But here, people gathered here, they can continue to make your another galaxy image and make a perfect image, whatever you want, along with this taking help from the astronomers. Yeah.
So I was just asking if it's all from the same galaxy, and if it's from the same galaxy, why do we also see them isolated? Like, no? This, it doesn't seem to be continuous and things like that.
Once the jet is ejected, it is having its own momentum to go out. And even after the jet is stopped, there is surrounding medium which has its own movement. Like the smoker can be standing here, it smokes, but the wind carries that smoke somewhere else. Similarly, this smoking black hole's jet is also left on the outskirt without any force to go anywhere. So it is diffusing, dispersing in any direction. If wind is coming from somewhere, it will get carried away in that direction. So they are asymmetric. When it is active, it is very momentum-driven, powerful. That time it is looking symmetric. But the outer one is not symmetric. Neither this is diffusing at the same rate. So the bottom one is brighter than the northern one. Neither they are symmetric in location. They have many different other environmental processes that is affecting it. It's the rare case because the event itself is a rare thing. It is possible there is one galaxy 3C75 where two jets, independent jet, one side they got merged and become one stream, like river merging. Yes, you have a question.
Mind the time scale. How do we qualitatively determine the time scale of this jet with respect to the galaxy?
This kind of galaxies where this straight edge brightened lobe are seen, it is a bit straightforward. Suppose you assume the rate at which the relativistic plasma is going from the accretion process onto the black hole at a 0.1c, 10% of speed of light. And then you get the size of this thing, how many arc second. Knowing the distance to the central galaxy, what arc second corresponds to how many light year, you can now calculate. So divide by the 0.1c, you get a time scale, the expansion, dynamical time scale of them. There is one more time scale that is measured from the cooling rate of this plasma in some sense. If you have a good detector, you can say when the bullet engine was switched off. It is still hot, so how many minutes back it was switched off? It is already cold, how many minutes back it was switched off? So similarly, the PGSS, low frequency brightness, and the high frequency brightness, if you plot it, they can be curved if they are cooling. This leftover plasma, the relic plasma, that is cooling. So the spectrum will turn. And that turning of the spectrum, bending of the spectrum, can give you a handle since when the jet is not supplying more plasma there. There are different ways of finding the age. Anybody else has a question? Yes. Yeah, actually, it is supposed to evolve over time, and it has been evolving over time, but the time scale involved are millions of years. So in a day-to-day or a couple of years, you don't see changes happening on that large scale. But there is something called very large scale VLBI, very large baseline interferometry, where the resolution can be not arc second. Our planet stars are few arc second big. Moon is half a degree big, 30 arc minute big. So that few arc second, much smaller resolution they have, like milli arc second resolution. If you observe a jet coming out, just coming out from the black hole's accretion process, 2017, 2018, 2019, if you keep tracking them for years, you see the blob actually shifting their location. And that is where we have measured that the speed at which these clumps come out in the jet are 0.1c, relativistic speed, something that is actually observationally measured. Just you extrapolate that phenomena, the same radio jet, to larger scale. So it is not necessary that the plasma at the outer, this one, will have to be moving. But the central one, which is edge brightened, FR2 structure, the plasma jet moves very fast. What is the coordinate? I'm saying it's the angular size of the object.
Not that. In the query form, you specify the coordinates.
Array deck, right ascension and declination. That is like dividing the sky into latitude, longitude. So there are websites how to tell where the object is actually. So don't worry exactly which object to look for. The moment you find something, we teach students this something called DS9. There you can spot the object, their exact latitude, longitude. So that you share that latitude, longitude when you find something interesting. And that interesting thing will be found if more chances of discovery, if the data is new, if the data is more sensitive. So TGSS is the lowest frequency or the longest wavelength, most sensitive, high resolution data. 4-5 times better sensitivity, 4-5 times better in resolution. The chance of discovery from TGSS data is more. That's why I distribute TGSS file to different students. And they discover from their own data. So that whatever file I have given to one student, I will not give it to another one. So that they don't conflict. So that way they all are getting a chance to discover from their data and be part of the discovery as well as the research process in future. That's how in GMRT proposals, there are students 50% and non-student, all kind of professions 50%. See, this is the basic starting point, and more detailed understanding you will get after you getting to know what is the synchrotron process, what is an accretion onto the black hole, etc. But what simply I can say that the matter when it is falling to the towards the black hole, matter getting heated up, and that heated up thing doesn't remain an atom or molecule. So they are ionized, they are plasma. When a charged particle is moving, it is creating a current. When the current is there is a magnetic field. So you can imagine that the plasma when it is moving towards the black hole, it is getting compressed and the magnetic field is created by this flow of ion. And that magnetic field is so strong that the close to black hole also, the galaxy or close to black hole, the particles are getting more electromagnetic force than gravitational force. So this around the magnetic pole axis you can say that they escape from the galaxy. These are these jets. And when these jets, the particles are moving at relativistic speed, they are giving a kind of radiation called synchrotron. They are nature. That radiation's nature is different from the thermal radiation that you get from stars and gas.
I had two questions. They were related to each other. So is the 0.1c speed of the plumes, is it a constant? It is not.
It's not constant.
Okay. So has there been any discovery of any kind of star which has like a constant speed or which can be used as a standard candle in any way? So that like a general mass elliptical galaxy could have a specific mass and their plumes could be say of 0.1c or 0.2c and they could be comparative with each other?
I don't think the star word there, I understand. Why did you?
No, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have used star. I should have used galaxy. I'm sorry.
Okay. So the rate at which or the speed at which they will go up in the jet, multiple parameters to depend on.
Okay.
The rate at which accretion will happen, the rate at which black hole will be spinning. So there is no sacred number like 0.1c. But typical number for this edge-brightened, powerful galaxies are 10% speed of light. But it is possible that some can be low, some can be high. And furthermore, it is difficult to say something about the accretion rate at which matter is falling and the spin of the black hole. It is much easier to say mass of the whole galaxy. So that or the mass of the black hole we can also measure, indirectly of course. So we have very little handle on directly predicting whether at what speed, what parameter space, what will be the speed of the jet. It's difficult.
Have we also calculated at what inclination to the plane are the black holes bent towards? So like the plume, if you're observing a single plane, do we understand at what angle do the black holes eject them? Because if they're ejecting at the same rate, we can compare the rate going up or down and then kind of understand the redshift happening there.
There are proposals and studies how the spin of the black hole axis will be connected to the accretion disk spin. The matter that, like a solar system, it falls in a plane towards the black hole. So there is a general agreement that the accretion disk and the spin of the black hole will be orthogonal. And this spin of the black hole and the jet direction will be same, parallel. So that way one can say that the galaxy may be much bigger, can be of any orientation, but when it is feeding the black hole with a dust disk in the middle, dust disk and the jet directions are always orthogonal in elliptical galaxy. But that doesn't have any, the jet axis has no correlation with the orientation of the spiral galaxy. But when you feed, that are orthogonal. If it is rotating this way, jet will go like in the axis direction, spin axis direction. He is asking how to differentiate whether the plasma is from the background galaxy or from this galaxy. So it is a very difficult job. But when you make further observation, you can start seeing that the jet will be connecting to the host galaxy. If you go deeper in higher resolution, you will be seeing, where is my pointer? You will be seeing that the host galaxy center will be connected with the jet directly there. If you see that, then only you will start believing. For example, go to the Wikipedia article, you can see that jet. In the both the cases, the host galaxy will be in its very center. You can see this faint jet which connected up to this far. Here also, you will be seeing the jet is going far. So until you see that, you cannot be very sure. And you can be sure for this kind of cases, but when it is leftover plasma, it's very difficult. So there are various indirect way of telling that if the leftover plasma is too much behind, the luminosity or the true brightness becomes very large, unbelievable. So you will say that no, this is nearby. Nearby to the galaxy that is hosting here. Not every galaxy can have that kind of plasma, only massive elliptical can have. So which is the massive elliptical nearby? This particular one, not the other one. That is how most plausible explanation wise, this is the promising candidate for the host. So it is not necessary that every case we have to be sure that this is the host. What is important is we understand the physical process. There is observed 10 such sources, and what is the typical physical process that is happening guiding them? Anybody else?
And may other be blue shifted?
He's asking, depending on the line of sight, whether one of the jet will be blue shifted or the other one will be red shifted. Yes, this is true. But there is one point to note that the jet does not contain any atom or molecule or ionized gas. This is pure relativistic non-thermal plasma. So you don't observe actually any spectral line from there. The whole blob has no gas, no atom, no molecule. So there is no spectral line to get blue shift and red shift. But what you observe is something called relativistic boosting. By the time the jet is giving a photon towards you, half a second past, jet plasma is also reached closer to you. So with the same time, you actually observe more photon than it is supposed to be emitting. So that way, the approaching jet side, for example, this one, this is the approaching jet side, you see brighter, you see clumps are coming towards you. But the other side, immediately after that point, the black hole secretion, you don't see that. But when it starts interacting with the surrounding medium, it gets randomized. You will start seeing it. So the approaching side will get boosted up close to the core of the radio galaxy. That is what is showing that yes, things are coming towards me. Red shifted, but not measured in line wise. Anybody else? If you post your selfies, your this kind of RGB images with TGSS and tag us, join our group, Redatom. You will analyze more galaxies and you will be selected for the Redatom Discovery Camps happening next. The hosting institutes give your travel, stay, everything free because you are serving the nation's telescope's discovery free.
Excuse me, if you have a question, please raise your hand so that we can get the mic to you.
Yes.
Does our Milky Way galaxy still releasing this plasma jet?
Okay, good question. Everybody is curious whether we have AGN at the center.
And Andromeda also.
Yeah, both of the things I will answer that. See, as I said, these jets are released mostly by elliptical galaxies, right? So our Milky Way galaxy or Andromeda galaxy are not elliptical. They are not hosting a billion solar mass black hole. The mass of the black hole, billion times, 10 raised to 9 times, more massive than our own sun. They are not hosting that kind of massive black hole. But they are hosting relatively smaller black hole. Those black holes are million times more massive than sun. Not billion, but a million. So they have capacity to create a less powerful plasma outflow because they are just less massive. They may be spinning slower or at a lower number, but they have some power. So there are some plumes seen in our Milky Way galaxy, and people believe that this is from the small short episode of jet lighting ejection from our own Milky Way galaxy. Similarly, Andromeda also. The black hole at the center is seen in radio, but not like a long jet. But a very small jet comes out, then it has no energy to start. It could not start. The engine starts, but cannot create a longer jet.
If we just like put a Milky Way galaxy and things like that, or?
We see the radio plume in Milky Way galaxy, the long wavelength diffuse. But to be able to 100% sure that this has, when it has come and from where it has come, is still ongoing research. In Andromeda galaxy, something similar. That it is seen very low, but most of the scenes are things are seen in longer short wavelength current telescope. When we are building the square kilometer array, that will be 10 times bigger than the current vast array. So there we might be able to see even older cold plasma. And then we can be able to show that maybe 100 million year back, there was a plasma ejection from the Andromeda also. So this is a matter of sensitivity also, actually. It's possible that it has never happened, big jet ejection. But it's possible that, like Speca is an example, spiral can also create large jet. But it's still ongoing research. Anything else? RGB making, as I said, is just a starting point. And you need to go through 6 days training to become an e-astronomer so that you can be given a file to discover from that new, more sensitive data, TGSS. They first discover from the TGSS FITS file in DS9 and then start making this kind of RGB images to describe further where the galaxy, what kind of galaxy is that. Further question, we can end. We'll go back to RGB image analysis. People in the internet watching us live stream, they can post on their Facebook profile, and we will get back to them for improving their images, provided you come and join the Red Atom Facebook group, where 100 people are, and more than many people are waiting to help you whenever you wish. And then only you will be able to get selected for the camps.
So, is a supernova also a likely candidate for these kind of emissions?
No, supernova are very small stellar process. They give this kind of explosion. They create non-thermal plasma because they shock on the outband, but that is not related to the black hole's ejection process. They also give similar non-thermal plasma, but within the host galaxy itself. Stars are forming, those will be all giving radio radiation in the star-forming region of the galaxy, but not outside. This kind of jet are produced only by supermassive black holes, which go out of the galaxy. Want to close the live streaming now?
This is an announcement for the live stream viewers. If you have any questions for this session, you can post it in the chat and we'll try to answer those. Meanwhile, if there are any questions, you can ask.
Yes, please go ahead, you can ask. Any doubt? How can I participate from my home, from my college, anything? This is the page, this is the group you want to join to further discuss and analyze your images. Groups, facebook.com/groups/red@home. Somebody online has asked, it's been recently said that the center of our galaxy has 10,000 to 40,000 black holes lurking at its center. Is it possible they orbit the supermassive black hole at the center, or they show as a single one? Black holes are everywhere in our Milky Way galaxy. They are stellar mass black holes, few times mass of our sun. But the black holes that we have been talking about at the centers of our galaxies, they are million to billion times mass of the sun. So these small black holes, wherever there are O and B type star, massive stars are exploding in supernovae, they can form small black holes. As there can be a lot of gas and stars in the centers of a galaxy, there can be a lot of black holes near the center. So this is what is that? That a million solar mass black hole at the center can be surrounded by many stellar mass small black holes. That is what was discovered recently, that there are many small mass black holes around our center of a Milky Way galaxy. What we do not know currently is how these supermassive black holes have formed. Whether they have formed by merger of small black holes, or they have formed as a big collapse of gas. So this discoveries, like the small black holes around the center of our galaxy, and intermediate solar mass black holes, their discoveries, is going to help understand how actually supermassive black holes have formed in our universe. I will reply in text to this person, but I believe he has heard my answer. So all of you who have requested me to join this group, I will. I just basically check whether you are a real Facebook profile and you are Indian. I can't do more. There are 2,700 people roughly. And unless you come and start making RGB images, we can give you personal attention. Accepting everybody. I hope some of you are here in this hall. बंद हुआ है क्या लाइव स्ट्रीमिंग बंद है आई थिंक वी कैन क्लोज स्टार्ट 2 o'clock So in the group, this is the first post or pinned post. Here the process is described, how to make RGB images. Just the one I described you. So you need to create an image and post it in the group and describe the structure and color of spiral galaxies mostly. And then a lot of people will come and discuss there. They will comment how to improve your images, how to improve your understanding. This is how people are making images and posting. Everybody is just Skyview, save the image, post it within the group. If you have made selfie image and posted from your profile, you can share this inside also, once you are a member, of course. So that way you get the first-hand training of galaxies and radio galaxies and get selected to the camp training. These are other radio galaxy images they have made. Value they did not put actually, it is there in the image. It is there in the images, the brightness range in blue, brightness range in red. So you don't have to put anything, you just have to put, as I said, the galaxy name, which filter to put where. And develop your understanding that the blue looking region there are ultraviolet emitting young star, reddish region is older star like Sun. It's kind of very simple understanding of galaxies. Wikipedia article is sufficient for this.
One question. We are not sure about what happened at event horizon. How depth is singularity? How can we be so sure about the jet, plasma jet structure? Or there can be some hidden thing we still don't know about, some extra forces like which are contributing and we may analyze it wrong or...
See, this is a typical confusion that by definition, black holes are supposed to attract everything and even light cannot escape. And X-ray astronomer, optical astronomers, they spot black hole, they see that we have seen the observational evidence of that. So for most of the people, black holes don't radiate. For most of the astronomers, they radiate differently. That is why we say they are black holes. They are not normal objects. Mass is so high, size is so small, they change their variability so large, their emission process is so different, that is how we spot it has to be black hole. There is no other better explanation that we have. So all this jet that is coming out, all this plasma that I'm talking about, it is not within those event horizons. It is far beyond that. That is where the matter, not even radiation, the matter has come out of this accretion process, has gone up. So the theoretical understanding of this event horizon, Schwarzschild radius, all these things are far smaller than all this that I am talking about. So the emission process is so different that the central one, the central engine, has to be a black hole accretion process and we don't have a better answer. That is how we say they are black hole. Otherwise it will remain as a theory. Astrophysical black hole are one evidence that the black holes like thing exist.
So we can say that if a matter fall in the black hole, their X-ray radiations, they are not going to affect the jet plasma emission in a broad range?
No, the X-ray actually comes from a farther distance, in the accretion disk. The accretion disk, when the matter is falling, the turbulence and viscosity creates so much of heat that their temperature reaches 10 million degree, 1 million degree. So the peak of this thermal emission comes in the X-ray band. But the radio that is coming out is not accretion disk, not inside the event horizon or Schwarzschild radius, has not gone close to black hole. It is much before that all this thing happens. So the X-ray radiation is from the accretion disk, radio radiation is coming from the jet. There is rare cases, both can be seen little bit, but mostly this is the case. It's very different. Very different. And that is the mostly theoretical part. And we are focusing, trying to say, understand this black hole accretion process in a way that Chiranjeev Konar, my colleague here, he studies the time delay between different episodes of black hole. The first episode, the second episode, why black hole stop accreting and creating jet for 10 million, 20 million years. When the black hole, two black hole merge, it's possible the spin axis can also change and that can create another kind of radio galaxy. This is what people believe. So understanding this outflow, the jet plasma, can help us understand the bridge, the gap between the theory and the observation of black holes. Whenever you are posting, you just hashtag selfie with black hole and tag ICTS and Red at Home. We will get back to you.